Many people asking tonight on Twitter and Facebook and so on, is it getting worse? You know, we're in New York here. Hurricane Sandy was obviously the worst they'd had here for hundreds of years. Is it getting worse in terms of storm damage and power?
It's not clear. First of all, you can't say from any one storm that this is a result of, let's say, climate change. However, just looking at Chad Myers' graphic there, it's the width of this tornado that I think, at least to me, just looking at the data that are available online and stuff, that this is a much more powerful storm than the one that everybody talks about, May 3rd, 1999, because it's just wider, cutting a wider swath. So you got to figure it has, if it's twice as wide, you might figure it's got twice as much energy, but it might have four times as much energy, might have a 10 times, an order of magnitude as much energy. And this can be estimated by looking at the destruction. It sounds like, almost unbelievable, but you can assess the speed of the wind by looking at this video and looking for a piece of recognizable debris. This is all very, it's important going forward, but the destruction there tonight is really overwhelming. And I just want to remind us all that it's going to happen again. I mean, this is the 20th of May, and tornado season goes at least another month, and then hurricane season goes on all summer well into the fall.
I mean, the statistic I saw, which put it into real context, was that America gets at least 1,000 tornadoes every year. Mm. Last year, in the whole of the year, 70 people were killed by tornadoes. It would seem like the death toll here may well rise to that level at least, which is an illustration of just how deadly it's been.
In one event, yeah. And these houses, you'd think, as an engineer, you'd think you could design structures that could withstand this and that people would then be required by law to have access to them. But clearly, it's more complicated.
Well, I think in Oklahoma, there's a particular problem that they were saying earlier is that it's basically built on rock. And it's incredibly expensive for many of the homeowners to actually go down into the ground.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's
because
expensive.
Of the nature of the terrain there.
But then you can look at it another way. What does it cost to rebuild and what does it cost? The loss of people don't have now will not be able to make a living. They've lost their possessions and we're going to have to pitch in and help out. But it's going to happen again. I mean, if you got three of them in 14 years, you got to figure.